Hi, I'm Nicky Bleiel, DocuHelp's lead information developer. Welcome to the DocuHelp video training series. Today, I'm going to discuss how DocuHelp uses Word templates to transform your content and how you could edit those templates to customize the styles in your DocuHelp projects. If you author your content in Word, you customize your styles by editing Word templates. It's easy to edit the Word templates included with DocuHelp to match a corporate standard or create a custom look. If you are working in DocuHelp's built-in editor or HTML, you customize styles by editing cascading style sheets. In this lesson, we'll discuss editing templates. We'll cover editing cascading style sheets in another video in this series. DocuHelp includes two types of templates, the source and the target. The source template contains styles that you apply to your content. When you build your outputs, the target template transforms those styles so that your targets, whether they are online help, manuals, or EPUB, look and behave the way you desire. Please note that templates control the body of your online help targets. The skin, the headers, buttons, icons, and more are controlled by the theme. Customizing themes is covered in another video. DocuHelp includes several templates. To customize them, all you need to do is save the correct one with a new name, then edit away. You could change the formatting of any style, the font, the colors, the weight, the spacing, and more. The most commonly used DocuHelp templates are listed in this chart, but there are more. If you need to create manuals for A4 paper, for example, there are templates for that. Note that you use a single source template to apply styles to your content, but two different templates are used to transform your content. DocuHelp uses one to transform your content into a manual and another to transform it into most online help outputs. Please note that both manuals and online help are transformed with Word templates. So to transform your outputs, you need to edit the appropriate target template. There is no need to edit the source template because your end users never see it, but you can if you want to. More about that later. The default Word template for source documents, C1H No Margin, will be used for all new Word documents created in your project, as well as the existing documents you import into your project. The target template will vary based on what you are building, online help or a manual. It's as simple as that. By default, C1H PR No Margin is the template that transforms manuals. C1H HTML transforms online help. Well, all help outputs with the exception of WinHelp. The target templates displayed will change based on the target that is selected. Now that we have all of that out of the way, let's edit. First, we will save the target template for online help, C1H HTML, with a new name and edit a style. Choose Edit Template from the dropdown. C1H HTML will open in Word. Save the template with a new name, but keep the .dot file extension. Make sure to put target in the name so it is easier to identify later. And our new template is saved. To modify a style, just open the style pane and choose the one you want to modify. We'll edit the heading 1 style. Let's change the font color to red. Then make sure to choose automatically update and new documents based on this template. The style will update in the style pane. If you want to create a new style, just select the style that is closest to the one you'd like to create, choose modify, and give the style a new name. We'll change the font to 12 point in bold, and our new style is created. We'll find it down here under its new name. Let's save this template and close it. Now we need to add our new target template to the project. Click the target template dropdown and choose Add Template. The templates are all stored in the default Word template folder. We'll choose it from there and click Open. Now check to see that the template has been added to the project and build. As you can see, the Heading 1 style has been updated in our help output. The target template for manuals is edited the same way. In fact, when you edit the manual target template, C1H PR No Margin by default, You can also customize your cover with a logo or other graphics. Make sure to rename the template first. Before I sign off, there is one other thing I want to show you. Remember how I said you could edit and create styles in your target template and move them to your source template? It's easy to do. First, save the default source template, C1H No Margin, with the new name. After you've done that, edit your target template and use the Document Template button to open the Templates and Add-ins dialog box. Click Organizer. Our target template styles are on one side, and we can open our source template on the other. Now it's easy to move the target styles we modified and created into the source template. Close, save, and done. If you change the source template name after creating your project, use the Templates and Add-ins dialog box to assign the new source template to the existing documents in the project. Okay, I think that covers just about everything you need to know about templates. Thanks for joining me for this lesson of the Doc2Help video training series. Head to doc2help.com to download your free trial of Doc2Help. I'm Nicky Bleiel. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing Component 1.